From Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 185 pounds, Bobby Howard.
You have got to be kidding me. Look at this dweeb.
This guy is malnourished.
Malnourished? He's about to be like that steak you were just talking about for Mark Henry.
Bobby Howard looks to be frozen in fear.
Shape, let's go. You got this. Come on, I believe in you. Come on, come on. You got everyone cheering you on. Let's go. Come on, let's go. You got this. All right, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of him. Okay, you got this. All right, I believe in you. Come on, let's go. You got this. You're the man. You're my broski. All right, you can be broski of the week. You can be broski of the week. All right, let's go. Go.
On Mark Henry's face, not to mention the fear in the eyes of Bobby Howard, all of 185 pounds.
Yeah, but think about Mark Henry. I mean, he was expecting competition tonight, and he gets this guy. Mark Henry is embarrassed. He's been humiliated, and I think he's going to take all that frustration out on, what's his name, Bobby?
Wait a minute. Let's see how this thing play out.
Okay, well, we're seeing it right here.
Somebody get some A1 sauce in here, please.
Yeah, I mean, this is gonna be serious, though. This young man is.
Oh, my goodness.
This young man is in for the beating of his life. I mean, Mark Henry could end this thing right now.
Yeah, Mark Henry's already done enough to end this match.
I think Mark just wants to toy with this kid a little bit.
Well, listen, it's not about this kid. He's not toying with this kid. He's sending a message to the locker room. He's sending a message to our general manager. Sending a message to our chief operating officer, Triple H, that this mayhem and destruction from this man's going to continue.
This is just not good at all.
Oh, oh my Lord. I heard something pop. This kid.
One, two, three.
Ring the bell.
Did you hear that, Josh?
Here is your winner, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Oh, you're right. This was just clearly a demonstration.
Well, I mean, the kid was already the victim of world's strongest slam after world's strongest slam, and then Mark Henry tossing him around.
Wait.
Stop it, Mark. Now, Mark, now you and I go way back, but I just can't let you compete anymore. Mark, see, nobody wants to face you, man, and this isn't helping, all right? Come on, Mark, listen.
This is the trash you bring me.
Listen, Mark, I've got one lawsuit pending, and if I let you do this, it's gonna get worse, all right? Now stop it. I'll get you somebody, Mark, but just please.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, that's Sheamus. The brawler from Dublin, Ireland. The first ever Irish-born WWE champion.
To tell you that Sheamus, when I look at him, what I see is a man. That's what Sheamus is.
Look at Mark Henry.
Hi, Steady.
Teddy, if you were looking for a fella to fight him, I'll fight him. After all, he's just big. And as you said, Mark, bigger isn't better. You know, this reminds me of an old Irish story about a High King of Ireland, a man named Brian Boru. Now, legend has it, Brian had an illegitimate son. And one day an angry fairy came along with its magic wand, tapped that bastard on the shoulder, and turned him into one great, big, enormous, 425-pound bag of crap.
Going toe-to-toe and face-to-face with Mark Henry, but I also got a question. How wise is that strategy? Why in the world would you want to get in the ring and mix it up with a man as angry as Mark Henry?